Where do you two live? Like, what is the situ? What's the sit here?
Oh boy, I think we either live, I forgot, I never really decided between if we lived in a like double dorm with each other or if we lived in a really tiny ass apartment. And I was leaning towards apartment.
When you say tiny ass, like one bedroom that you like have two beds in, or what? Or like there's one bedroom, but you also sleep in the living room.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking, is like there's kind of a setup in the living room, like there's a futon, because like I always get back home late, or like whoever gets, pretty much whoever gets home first gets the bed. I think we just live in a little apartment. There's a kitchen, there's a living room, there's one bedroom, and we fucking make do.
This one is even better because it's like
It is
really
delicious.
shitty.
Oh yeah, that's pretty
So you
bad.
come in the hallway, and the hallway is the door into the bathroom. You come in the hallway, and then you've got basically the kitchen is in the hallway, right?
Yeah.
The TV is kind of there. There's like room for a table. The couch folds out, and then there's also the bed. So basically, whoever gets home first gets the bed. There is no
Yeah.
closet. You guys are just working with like whatever you've got. You've got like nightstands or tall nightstands or something.
This is
And the
perfect.
closet's in the hallway. Yeah, this is it's not quite the smallest apartment you could possibly have. This one has a bathroom, so it's not completely garbage, but
No, I've seen some worse ones on TikTok within the last week, so don't even worry about it.
yeah. But this is actually looks like the place that I stayed for some of my master's program stuff.
Nice.
Yeah. Anyway, all right. So, not big at all. When are you getting home? What's going on after? What is it? When is this after?
This is
The rescue of the
after,
frog?
yeah. So after interviews with all of the agents working and
Okay.
talking and retalking and waiting and all this stuff, just classic like little meddling government interference shit. An incident that ended at like 1 o'clock in the afternoon, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. You're not getting home until like 9 because everybody has to say we're closing the perimeter, all this stuff. And just, all this crap. So
Agreed.
she's not getting home like past midnight, but she is home later than she thought she was gonna be.
So you walk in, when you open up the door, she's on the phone. And she is on the phone with who she's on the phone with. Who did she She's not still in contact with your family, obviously. So who's she on the phone with?
I mean, it would be an interesting thing if she did still have contact with the family. She probably doesn't, but it might be interesting if she does. Because just like very cordial, like, how are you doing? Are you doing
Okay.
well? We're doing fine, whatever, all this stuff. Or it could very well be that she's on the phone trying to get, deals or like sponsorship deals or anything like that.
I think it's not either of those things. You're catching a whiff of this thing that you've gotten occasional hints of before, is that she's got somebody that she still talks to at Second Son. Okay? Okay, so you're walking in and it's like, okay, no, I understand. So they're gonna launch another. Okay, it's fine. It's fine. Yeah, I gotta go. I gotta go. All right, bye. Hey, there's stuff in the fridge. I cooked earlier. I figured you were gonna be late because of the thing in the bay. She comes around like into the hallway as you're still like putting your stuff.
It's always these. Is it Aegis again?
This is
The
initiative.
initiative.
Yeah.
It's always the fucking initiative coming in and always having to like slobber their prints all over everything. Like, we had it handled. The boat was like, I mean, you know how it is. We
Well,
always, it always goes like this.
they have to come in when they're like, this is the problem, is you arrested people, right? It looked like there were people getting arrested. You can't arrest
Yeah.
people. This is what we got to talk about. I'm just saying,
He's.
if you got official badges, like official like sanction, I know you don't want to, and it's fine. We don't have to, but this is the other side. If you don't do that, then they've got to do this.
It's like not even really about me. That's the problem. You know what I mean? Like, it's not me. Like, I would get a badge, you know? You know how happy I would be to just be able to fucking pick up a guy and drop him right on Initiative's doorstep and just be like, hey guys, another catch for the day, right? We got this guy on our team. He's got some, you know, stuff going on. I don't think it would be great to, like, I don't think they would give him a badge.
So
You know what
listen,
I mean?
we haven't had a chance to talk about T this. You keep using the T word. And so,
I'm a genius, right?
okay, so one of the team members is somebody that you can't use do initiative stuff with because they're
We're
what now?
working on it. We're working on it. It's a work in progress. I promise. It's a work in progress.
Yeah.
Okay? We're it's
So is a leg injury. Like, so.
That's fair. That's no, because that's fair.
So you have the barista,
Yeah.
the.
Who doesn't know how to talk to people at all? Like,
Yeah, I noticed that in the interviews. It's half barista, half deer in the headlights. It's not great. And then there's the
Oh, it's not half barista. It's all deer in the headlights.
so and then you've got the apologetic homeless person and the angry homeless person and the zookeeper. So honestly, the
The
frog
frog
is the
is
most photogenic.
great.
No, the frog is the most photogenic person of all of you, and I'm counting you half the time. No offense.
Ooh, that's rude. Hey, I look great all the time. I do. Hey, no, I do.
You
I
do.
look great.
You do. But put a
The
mask
frog,
on the
don't get
frog,
me
you're
wrong.
still if you
The
put a
frog is
mask on the
great.
if you put a mask on the frog, you're still going to lose to a popularity contest. But the rest, what is deal like? Also, we should probably get a mask for the frog because I would act I'm seriously, he would fucking do numbers.
I know, right? The pinchador, you know, just a little thing over the top. Get him, yeah.
No.
It's good stuff. I'm working through it. The problem is,
Did you adopt them?
none of them. I no. Adoption implies some sort of authority. They don't listen to me at all. It's really bad,
You're
actually.
doing a
I don't know what I'm doing.
heat up the food. You're doing a great job of selling me on this, by the way.
There's good and bad. There's good and bad. They're great people. They're fantastic heroes. I can see the future of them. Like, I can see the image in my head. It's beautiful. It's crystal. Yep. See what I did there? Crystal wings. Oh, this is why they pay me the big bucks.
That joke is never gonna go. You keep trying to make it happen, and it's not. No.
It's better than
No.
all the shit that the fans are doing with, like, the Christ stuff and the religion stuff with me. I don't want to be Jesus incarnate, but so I'm trying. We're shifting the focus. Don't get me wrong. I know it's not perfect,
Okay.
and I'm doing my best,
Okay.
but I genuinely think that there's something here. This is moldable. I just got off the phone with Liam. She wants a makeover.
Which one's
A
Liam?
makeover. He's the ex-terrorist.
Jamie, you're muted, but it looked like you said apologetic homeless person. Yeah, you did. Okay, that's good. I can read lips. Okay. So wait, sorry. What did you just say? He's what?
Was that a secret?
No, seriously, what did you just say?
Ex-terrorist. It was, he said he's never hurt any, he's redeemed. People love redemption arcs. Fuck knows why. People love them. They sell. People love the redemption. And he is as classic as he get. He's even a white boy. He'll
Does
do great numbers.
Initiative know that he's
Yeah, they're helping him through that. That's why I said the whole thing about they can't give him a badge, because he's like still growing.
He's
He's
clean
got a
slate? He's in clean slate.
lot.
You have a clean sl
Yeah, he's great.
Oh my God, I'm gonna die. This is what death feels like. It's coming that I'm gonna die from a brain aneurysm. She's
I
over
am
at
not.
like the little table with the two chairs and it's just like with her face, just the palms, heels of her hands just straight up into her eyes, just like pressing.
Listen, I know it's not ideal. Nothing about this is ideal. And I would love your help trying to make it work, because I'm grasping at straws. But there's potential. You can't tell me you don't see the potential.
See what
Think
you're
about it.
saying.
Really breathe.
I see what you're thinking.
Breathe.
I see what you're
Think
thinking.
about it.
But listen, all you're doing is thinking, and you're not looking at how people are going to feel about this. And this is, I know that when you think about how people are going to feel about things, you start to feel things about things, and then you feel bad. But you
We need
have,
a name.
that's
We need a team
not
name.
what I said. That is, you're, it's just
You're a genius.
she's trying to shift your labels before you go down this road.
Yeah.
She thinks,
She's just, I'm just trying to dodge.
Jamie is, the thing is that Jamie manages to do this, like she's on mute, but she's still like gesticulating wildly. This is the thing. It's like eventually at some point in time, I'm going to have this on a podcast broadcast, you know, like where there isn't the video and people are going to miss out on what's essentially an entire circus performance going on in Jamie's window. It's fantastic.
Spotify has
No,
video.
here's the thing. I was like, the second you were like, you're just thinking, not feel like thinking about the emotion. I was like, he's trying to shift your labels. I fucking know it. He's shifting your labels.
Of course I am.
I kind of knew how that was gonna happen going into it.
So I think
I keep forgetting the sister's name. I'm like, I
well,
made it, and I'm continuously
all
forgetting.
I know is that it's a V.
It is definitely a V. It's Valerie and
Verity or something?
Verity. Yeah, I do think it's Verity, actually. You're so correct. I
Am
think it's Verity.
I? So I'm trying to decide if she's telling you how you are or telling you how you need to be.
I think she's telling me how I need to be because she's talking about like you're doing this thing and here's what you actually need to be doing.
Okay. So what she's
And
telling.
that's more like what you're supposed to be doing.
Yeah. In that case, then what she is doing is she's doing superior down, mundane up. You need to be more thinking about how people feel about stuff and a little bit less thinking about the tactics of things that don't take people's feelings into account.
I'm kind of good with that. I'll do that.
You're listening, you're hearing her.
I'm hearing her.
So superior down to a three, a one, and mundane up to an up, I want to say, up to a negative one.
A negative one.
Okay.
Thank God somebody in this house thinks I need to do this all better.
So listen. The guy, what's his name?
Which name?
Pick one.
Liam or the Celtic Bull.
No,
I
you
know,
are
it's
fucking with me
terrible.
right now. You are
No,
telling.
it's bad, isn't it? He's very Irish. You have to forgive him.
Is he?
I think so.
Obviously, or he wants to be really bad. Jesus, does he have like a freaking Fighting Irish tattoo on his Notre Dame tattoo on his bicep?
That's
Okay,
probably a
okay,
trans
okay.
never
So
come to mind.
his costume is just what he's been in lately, which is like.
Yeah, it's the like ex machina uniform of like, I was it's literally screams I used to be a terrorist. It's really bad.
But
It's
during
really
COVID,
bad.
because of the face mask. Gotcha. Okay.
Yeah.
Celtic Bull. That's not like we can't costume them. What are we gonna do?
I don't know. He seemed really upset. I don't think it was his
Oh, I'm
idea.
definitely gonna make him feel better about it. Sure.
Yeah.
What can he do?
He's got the metal manipulation thing. He can, fuck with metal.
What does that have to do with what?
I don't know. Again, I got really excited about this team thing, and I was like, oh, these guys are such cool superheroes, and we all fought together to, save the British ambassador. And I was like, yeah, awesome. Why is nobody else as excited about this as me? It just keeps getting worse. Every time I think about this, about the people, I said hand-picked, Verity. Hand-picked. That's gonna haunt me to my grave. I would never hand-pick these people. That's mean. Is that mean?
Yes.
Do I really think that?
Oh my God.
Oh.
Yes. I have to tell you this. We're twins. Did I eat your heart in the womb?
Oh, God, I wish.
Okay, you're not helping.
No. I don't know what to do, V. I'm
Okay.
mad.
Don't say V. That could be you. You'd be talking to yourself.
I'd never talk to myself unless I'm standing in front of a mirror.
Wow. Okay.
I mean, we definitely need to do something about everything.
Well, we don't have a budget for what we should, because if you can do metal, what we should be doing is dressing him in like an armor suit or something like that. Because if he's with Clean Slate, can he get any budget from Initiative?
I can ask, but I should probably ask him to ask them because I'm not Initiative. They're not my biggest fan right now, I'll be honest. They seem to like him. He's got a great. He seems to be doing really well. But they don't like me.
Cut to a flashback of Special Agent Delaney at the end of the dock going, "What the fuck were you thinking?" He seems to like him. Yeah. And then back to you in the apartment.
Know,
yeah,
sure
they get along great. It's fine.
Yeah,
she's scrolling
sure,
on her.
Sure
go ahead.
Ask.
She's scrolling on her phone. She goes, "Okay, well, okay, I get." Why they went? I mean, Celtic Bull is because if he was going to do
totally Irish,
yeah. But if you do the Irish, like the mythic Irish Smith, and his name is Goibnew, no, this isn't gonna. That doesn't work. God dang.
I don't like it. Green is a little leprechaun. Like he's ginger. You know what I mean? Like he's ginger. Like no soul ginger kind of intensity. You know what I mean? So, like, putting him in all green, you know, it would lean into the Irish thing, but
no,
that they just look like
really
a leprechaun.
That's really gonna be bad. That's probably gonna be
bad.
What was the name of the leprechaun on the cereal? Does he have a name?
Hold on. Lucky Charms leprechaun.
Kiernan, we're only roasting you in effigy, not actually directly. I just want to make that clear.
Name? No, I don't want a picture. You'll love this. Lucky the Leprechaun, the original. Also known as Sir Charms. We could call him Sir Charms.
Can we? I don't want to.
So I could. He seems charming.
I don't.
What have I got myself into?
A PR nightmare. And
yeah. Good thing I have you.
Maybe we don't do the Celtic thing. Maybe we do like a...
I'm not sure if he's looking for a name change. I'll be honest with you.
Oh, don't do that. You almost did an Irish accent there. Don't do that. Is he rubbing off on you? Wait, is he rubbing off on you?
That was entirely an accident. I'll be honest, Dad. That was just me being dumb.
Well, just the way you were lilting, it was just a little bit.
No, you're right. I heard it. I just hope that nobody would notice.
So if he doesn't want to do a name change, fine, we'll do the Celtic Bull thing. We just need to, honestly, we just don't worry about it. Maybe we, like, get some
body armor. We just need him in something a little bit less military. Or maybe we lean into the, no, we don't lean into the military.
No, we do like
the military?
We do, no. We do the plate armor thing, but we give him like a helmet that looks like a bull.
Ooh, that's kind of, okay, all right. I'm opening my notes app.
Maybe.
Got it?
I don't know. That might be really bad. I don't know how it's going to play. It's cool. We could go full on superhero and just go freaking Silver Age and just go just bananas with this thing.
Yeah.
That would be pretty cool. I mean,
let me see
already ridiculous.
See if he has any inspiration, you know, just like, you know, just see if he's got any guys that he likes.
It would probably work because you're already like ridiculously over the top and just like.
Yeah. I saw this adorable leotard in a store the other day,
no.
And it was just like so. No, not for him.
I meant
not
for
him.
You,
no.
No.
Not for me either.
No.
For Dal. She's got like the gymnast thing going on.
Who's
and
Dal?
She kind of like blends the fog, the girl with the fog.
The stick?
She kind of like
Why
blends.
Is she stick? She doesn't have a quarter staff or anything.
Now, this is genius.
Huh?
You'll love this.
Uh-huh.
It's because she always sticks the landing.
That's pretty fucking good. I like that one.
I know,
that's
right?
good. No, that's
I
good.
Know,
that's good.
Right?
I like that. That's good.
Hashtag. That's a hashtag.
Stick the landing. I can use that. That's good.
Mm-hmm.
Should make her work on the other guy.
I know, right?
Because I got
Maybe that. I'll just keep them in close proximity.
Plate mail.
I'll trap them together. So what have you been doing all day?
Reading about how you are all showing up in the news.
Mm-hmm.
And
well, that's a terrible lie. Who were you talking to on the phone when I came in?
Sorry?
Are you sorry? Who are you talking to? Are you dating somebody?
No.
You're not allowed to date without telling me.
I am absolutely allowed to date whoever I want, whenever I want, and I don't have to tell you. as long as I don't bring them back here. Which, and I'm not dating anybody, so.
So, who are you on the phone with? Come on. You know you want to tell me.
I super don't.
Mom, I'll check your phone log while you're sleeping. We have the same fingerprint.
I was getting a little bit of an update from the second son. Not from them, but about them.
Who? Mom and dad?
No. No.
Oh, yeah. Okay. No, I didn't think so. Who? Wait, how? You have a connection in there? Wait, how? Wait, no, sorry, not important. What did they say?
So,
what's the update?
It sounds like Halo might be coming to town for a PR thing. Oh. And apparently they're going to be sending him with somebody new.
From the collective.
Somebody new.
They're putting out another one?
It's another angel-themed. Do you remember... Before we left, do you remember the little blonde kid? She was like 3 years younger than us.
Oh, yeah. Oh, God. Blanking on the name.
Well, I don't know that we ever even knew what it was.
Just this little tiny petite thing. Just, yeah.
Apparently, yeah. That's the new Uriel.
So they, name. Oh, God, that's awful. That's what.
Yeah, the pee jokes are going to be coming fast and furious on that one, I'm pretty sure.
Clearly. Oh, that's terrible. Jesus, they've always been bad at this. Okay.
Oh, this might work.
What?
She holds up her phone. She's multitasking. She holds up her phone and does, and shows you this in the inspiration. Like, maybe like
Yeah, actually, that would be good. That gives him more, like, ammunition. He can almost sculpt this himself.
I'm thinking, like, well, yeah, if we give him enough. Wait, can he actually bend stuff? Like,
Yeah. He's like a tall girl, you know?
I don't know who that is.
Oh my God. Are you nervous?
Is it from that cartoon? The thing with the. Okay.
It's good. It's so good. Oh God. I've got to make you sit down and watch that at some point.
Ooh, this is even better. Wait.
Yeah, no. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
How much is Etsy going to cost us?
No, Etsy. He'll do it himself. All the metal stuff. It's good.
Wait, look at this one. Good. This is good. We could try.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that. I mean, yes, but also no. And she's sending them all over to Liam. So, like, Liam's just getting like, how's this? Do you think you can do this? Like, how? So, going back to the other thing, they're both coming here.
Who?
Halo.
She's trying so hard to.
Yuri smell.
She's been trying. You know? She's been trying so hard to change the subject. They're here already.
They're here? When did they get here?
They're going to do a launch in the next couple days, so I don't know. They don't know when they got here, but they're going to do a launch. Like.
Okay, so you're giving me shit about ruining PR with the team thing, and you didn't tell me about this?
Well, we can't go fight a bunch of... These guys are sanctioned. They're not good. We can't, like, go and do a showdown.
No, obviously. I would have done that a long time ago. People love those guys, and my whole thing is their thing, and they do it better.
What?
How am I gonna? Well, they've got the numbers. People love Halo, and if he's got another copy of him, but the girl version.
We don't
from the same place.
We don't have to do them. We do something else. We do a different thing than them.
Oh, what? What is that?
We do this frickin' ragtag bag of fucking...
Say it. I know you want to say it. Use the T word. I have a list of names.
Squad.
A squad. It's close enough. It's good enough. Hold on.
We do that because they're very much not what the...
I have a notes app second for you. It's a list of names. Okay? Some of these... I'm pretty happy with a lot of these. Okay, haven't run them through the team yet.
How are you the oldest?
You know, you're my number one. Oh my God, I cannot find this anywhere. Okay, you're ready. You're not ready. These are fabulous. Okay.
Pause. As you're about to give the names and everything, we're going to switch to
Razzmatazz.
Oh my God. What?
I'm going to Razzmatazz her.
Brooklyn. Hi. Sorry. That went on for a bit.
Hi.
It was really good, though.
Hey, Mom, we need to talk about Dad. I believe that was the last thing you said, right?
Oh, I forgot about that.
And of course I do this, and right then they lock. Sad trombone. I love it. All right. So the last thing that you said at the end of the last session was, Mom, we need to talk about Dad, after Grant was all tucked in. Right? Now, she, remind me, she's like a, she's a teacher or an archaeologist or a historian, or what is her deal?
Like, she's a director at the
museum?
Like, city's museum. Yeah.
Okay. And your dad was something similar to that?
Yeah. They kind of, they fell in love together in the same field. Like.
Gotcha. Okay. Yeah. He was, yeah, his specialty was more in, I want to say something like, his specialty was maybe something more in like linguistics or something. So studying anthropology / archaeology, so ancient languages,
yeah,
you know, deciphering,
yeah, he
wrote, you know, Rosetta Stones and things like that.
Yeah, he did a lot of traveling for that too, which is
he used to until a horrible thing was done to him.
Yeah.
Anyway, all right, so yeah, you guys get into like. If she's going to sit down and talk with you, where's that going to be? Like in the kitchen, in the living room? Where is that?
So, like, very, like, open concept sort of home. With, so, there's this one hallway leads to all the different rooms.
Sorry.
It's okay. You're echoing back through your own mic. So I'm getting, sorry. Go ahead. And
so kind of like kitchen / living room, kitchen's over here, living room's over here, and it's kind of separated by like an island place.
Sure.
So like I'm Sticks or Dal is sitting
like
on one
at
the side
counter?
Of
the
yeah.
Okay.
And
I gotcha. Sitting. I gotcha. You basically described our kitchen and living room, basically.
Oh, perfect.
Okay. So what brought this on?
So we had a run-in with, well, you know how I've been with that group of superheroes, and you know how my frog's super big, and basically we ran into the scientist, and I think he might have some sort of information on Dad. And I know his death happened when I was still, like, relatively young. But I didn't hear a lot about it. It was just, yeah, Dad left on a trip. Surprise, he died. Now we're at a funeral.
Well, okay.
We're grieving.
Now I feel bad that I didn't take care of you well enough during all of that. That I'm sorry. I was surprised by it too, obviously. I didn't mean for you to not know to. Sorry, what were you asking? Because now she's like going down this blame spiral of how she handled breaking the news of to you about your dad, and definitely
basically,
not on focus.
Basically, I'm asking like what, like I know Dad was in with the museum and he was doing translating stuff, but what did he actually do?
Okay.
Like was there secrets?
So
that he was.
There's a couple. She's not gonna immediately. So she's kind of busying herself around everyone with the eyeballs. It's funny. She's kind of busying herself around the kitchen a little bit. And oh man, this is bad for you. No matter what you do on this one. There's a couple different ways you can approach this, where you can kind of say, well, I'm going to kind of like lay some of this guilt on her for how this was all handled and kind of provoke her into doing this. Or you can kind of go the pierce the mask route of what do mm-hmm. I, how can I get you to tell me about my dad kind of thing. But both of those, one of them is a superior role and one of those is a mundane role, and you're bad at both of them. So it's really up to you. Are you going soft sell, play on the feelings, read who your mom is kind of thing, or do you want to go with the kind of more of a emotional strong arm thing of I'm going to make you feel bad about this, so you tell me things?
I feel like at this point, like, she's hidden everything away from me. Like there was never much talk about what happened, and like I didn't even know how he died. Like, all I knew is that it was, like,
yeah,
surprise. Like, he went on a trip and he was killed in a freak accident.
I got you. So which one do you feel like that's, like, are you forcing it a little bit, or?
I feel like I'm kind of guilting her, because, like, I feel like as a mother, you kind of need to, like, at least mention once they're a little bit older, like, hey, like,
I gotcha.
This is what actually happened.
So what I'm going to have you do is I'm going to have you roll superior, but when it asks you if you have any modifiers, take a plus one, or put a one into the modifier, because kind of treat it like you have influence over her. At least for this one off here, I think you probably have the effective influence on her for this. So
wait, so superior?
Yeah, rolling superior, because you're kind of provoking her. You're using that guilt kind of. Yeah. You're not trying to read her and figure out the perfect thing to say. You're kind of just going, hey, this is kind of shitty. You should be better a little bit. Oh, look at that. That's a 9. Nice job.
Wow.
Okay, so let me just look at the move here. Provoke. When you are doing a provoke, say what you're trying to get them to do. On a 7 to 9, so on a 10, they'll do what you want. On 7 to 9, they can instead choose one. They can still do what you want. So stumble, you get a critical opportunity. Okay, yeah. So this is going to feel like a fail, but it's not really a fail. A 7 to 9, you may not get them to say what you want them to say, but
they can.
But you're going to get one of these other options. So what she does is she goes, I don't know what you're implying about this. I'm not trying to hold anything out on you. And I'm not trying to lie. I've never lied to you about any of the stuff. I mean, he was traveling and then he died. And I'm sorry that I didn't tell you about any of that, but that's just, you know, I was dealing with a lot of it too, because I mean, you lost your dad. I lost my husband. It was just really bad. And I'm not trying to, like, I don't know what any of this has to do with anything, or you risking your life with your crazy giant frog. And this is a lot for me to deal with right now. And she storms out of the kitchen and kind of into her room. She doesn't slam the door, but you are going to permanently get influence over her. She overreacts and she's totally zoned in on what's going here. So what's happening here? I'm going to mess with your character sheet for a second. You have influence over my mom, which is, basically, whenever you're doing any role with her, you're going to get that plus one is just going to continue. Mm-hmm. You can follow her. The conversation is not closed off, but the strong arm thing got you this, where she's kind of like got a bit of a gap here, but she's also kind of overreacting a little bit. So you got to kind of come at this from a slightly different direction. So what are you doing? You're sitting at the counter and you're kind of like, there's that moment of, what the fuck just happened? Did she?
Yeah.
She, what?
Yeah.
What do you do?
So I can follow her?
You can absolutely follow her and continue the conversation. She didn't slam the door. She stormed out of the room, but you can absolutely follow her, continue this. Or honestly, you know your mom well enough. You could even do something right from here. Like, she doesn't even need to be in the room for this, but you can do a pierce the mask and try to read what just happened.
Mm-hmm.
And go, I could, you know, if you roll decently enough, you can get an answer here about, like, what the hell, because you're kind of going, what the hell just happened? And if you step back for a second and kind of think about this, you might be able to, like, the answer might present itself.
Mm-hmm. Is there any way that I could get her to come back into the room?
I think, like, that you need to pierce the mask and figure that out.
Okay. I'll pierce the mask then.
I don't know. I honestly don't know the answer to the question until we find out, like, how much download. So in this case, again, modifier, you get a 1 in the modifier box. Don't just roll straight.
Okay.
In this one, you're doing mundane.
Okay.
But you still get the 1 in the modifier box, because you have the influence now.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, influence is great because it applies to any role that you have pointed at that person. Directly engage, defend, pierce the mask, comfort and support. It works on everything.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm just going to, like, sit back and
think,
like,
think for a second about what you could say, or what hopefully you don't hope it blow the roll. That would be sad. Actually, I know exactly what will happen if you blow the roll. So it'll still be awesome. Don't worry about it.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, fuck. Oh, no. Oh, dear. Okay. All right. Mark potential. So that's fun. Oh, you have. Was that the fifth one, or did you already have five marked?
I already had five marked.
Did you pick up a thing, or were you still thinking about it?
I was still thinking about it.
Okay, so let the record show that you have six now, and you need to pick your advance.
Okay.
Oh, wait, you have in here under advancements, take a move from another move, take another move from the playbook. But what did you take? Hunger and When We Were Apart were already in there. The Friend was already in there. Lookout and Communion were both in. So you were going to take another move maybe from your playbook, but you don't have it marked down what it was. We'll come back to it in a second. So what do you say to get her to come back out?
Because, like, I was, like, decently close with my dad, mm-hmm. and, like, we were best friends. Like, he kind of, like, got me, like, out in the forest and exploring around, and that's kind of where I fell in love with frogs. And he just kind of did everything with me. And so I feel like possibly I could ask her or say, like, hey, like, I miss him too, and, like, I just want answers about my best friend.
Do you call it out to her, or do you go, like, into the, like, the door of the bedroom and say that? I say that I asked just because of how I staged this.
Yeah. So, I get up from the chair and I walk towards, like, the... like one room, and like I kind of swing myself like into the doorway, and like I kind of like Dal kind of just like leans up against the corner, and she says that her mom, once she like looks up at her.
So you come in and are leaning on the doorway, and she says, oh, that I don't think it's very fair to try to guilt me about something like this you lost somebody. I lost years. We were married for so, like, she keeps saying things and then like cutting herself off halfway through the sentence. I don't know what you think it has to do with the scientist, or you're trying to connect it to your frog or whatever. It's ridiculous. Listen, he was a linguistics expert. He was working on, this is Halcyon. Weird stuff happens. There was an alien ship in the middle of the bay. They were trying to decode the languages, and he was working with somebody over in England. He went over to talk to them, and then that happened. Okay? It's that. And I don't want to talk about it. It was a stupid thing. It wasn't even connected to the rest of it. He was just caught in some freaking terrorist thing because he happened to be over in England during the Troubles. That's it. And that's all that it is, and I'm done. I'm going to bed. And she slams the door in front of you. And I'd like you to take a powerful blow.
Okie doke.
Because it was
this might be the most painful thing that you've ever done to me. This makes me so sad.
I didn't do it to you. Way to make
it about... I want to hug this woman so much.
Sorry.
I just want to be like, oh my God.
For take a powerful blow, you hit the conditions dice up at the top. And
you're right. You didn't do it to me. And that's how bad this is.
Okay.
It hurts.
And I don't add the one for this.
You don't add the one for this. This is just, it's going to, it rolls and it adds, it's just a D6, but it or 2D6, but it adds your conditions. And you have one right now. So, and then we just look at that and see what that does. That is a 7. That is too bad, because the middle result in take a powerful blow is not a fun ride. Okay. So I'm gonna let me just show to the players here. Take a powerful blow. Just to make it really clear so everybody understands the mechanics, this is basically rolling straight off of the 6. So fail, you get exactly the answer you want, and you wish you didn't get it, because it's bad news. So on the 7 to 9, you pick one of these things. You lash out verbally at one of your teammates, provoking them to some sort of foolhardy action, or you take advantage of your influence over one of your teammates, and they take a condition as you rant on the phone to them about this horrible thing that happened. You give ground, your opposition gets an opportunity. I'm not 100% sure what that would look like, but there's probably something you could do there where you race off to talk to the scientist who's in initiative hands and try to ask him questions about all this, or I don't know what that would look like. Pick something, we'll figure out what it looks like. And you struggle past the pain. This is horrible, it sucks, you feel terrible, and you take 2 conditions, which is you rocking yourself to sleep in your bedroom and crying or something. I don't know. Take a powerful blow is the worst,
I feel like I feel like in this situation, she's like just really, really frustrated because she was expecting to get answers out of her mom, or like different answers.
Yeah.
More out of her than that. Because she still believes that there's more going on behind her dad. Like it, yeah.
Although the fact that he was like using his linguistics stuff to like decode alien languages, what the hell? Is certainly a weird thing, but wait, you muted somehow for some reason. Like, oh, there you go. You're back.
So yeah, I just think it's like a weird situation to,
how
like,
do you think you are?
Why was he?
Yeah. So what do you, how are you reacting to this? What's your choice here with this?
Frustration, I feel like I think I'm gonna like give, I want to give someone a call. I like that.
Okay. And you basically just rant at them until they take a condition on your behalf.
Yeah. Like trauma dump, like really hard, make them cry.
Who do you have influence over right now?
Take a look.
That should be.
I've influence
Chris,
over
Chris and Liam.
Liam, yeah.
And Chris. So I want to make it clear what happens in this mechanically is that you call them.
I'm pretty sure everyone should have.
You should absolutely trauma dump on Liam. Oh my god.
Liam.
That is what I'm going to do. I'm going to trauma dump so fucking hard on Liam.
Oh fuck! I love this fucking game.
Do you have guilty? Because you should take it just in advance.
Okay.
But also, I just want to make sure that Brooklyn Sheet is right, because everyone should have influence over me.
Oh,
I haven't.
You're right.
Influence away from
yeah,
anyone.
I might. I might not have put. Yeah. You. So I will put Calamity in there. Okay, but Liam should definitely be. So thank you for correcting it, but yes, at the same time, it should absolutely be Liam. I want to make it clear how the mechanics work, because so this is how this works. You call up somebody you got influence in, you're trauma dumping. They take the condition instead of you, but the way it's the, and I'm just calling out the wording, is fine because it's a fixable thing down the road. Relationships go like this, right? But it says, take advantage of your influence to inflict a condition. What that means is he'll take the condition, you lose influence. He's got to close down a little bit, so he's not going to have, you're not going to have influence on him. You don't permanently lose it, you can get it back later. But for a while, he's got to shut down because there's a knife and it's being shoved into his spleen of emotions, and he should withdraw from that. Okay, so. So you get in your room and you call and you're like scrolling through your contact list and you're like, god, no, not Remedy. Chris is going to be talking to her sister. I don't want to, like, I guess I just need to talk to somebody. And you hit Liam. Calamity mentioned something about being on like a feature phone with a pay as you go plan, and you don't want to like burn up all of her minutes. So I mean, it's fair, right? Oh, that's the other thing. I got, not to tangent, but I got to tell you this. My guy who's in the other Mass game that I'm playing, who's from the, like, from 1989 and jumped forward, he does energy projection, but he can't control it very well. His future self can control it really well. I can't use touch screens because I make them, they glitch because the energy project. So I can't use, and I hate all the new tech anyway, because it's like, we got the worst dystopia. Like, it's just the shitty rain from Blade Runner, but none of the neon and none of the chrome. And it's just like, everybody is just carrying around glass rectangles. And all they do is watch ads. It sucks. It's like the worst dystopia. It's like the worst possible future. So yeah, he carries around like a Nokia 6130 and he does T9 texting. Because he can't use anything else. Anyway, all right, so you call Liam. Liam, your phone, it's Dal. I gotta know, like, what's the ID photo on this call? Like, what did you take a picture of for Dal? Is it Dal? Is it the frog? Is it the two of them? Is it just a D? Like, does it just show the first? You haven't done a picture?
It's an emoji. It's one of the emoji ones. It's the emoji of a frog.
Oh, the emoji of a frog? Nice. I love it. All right, so yeah, it's Dal. How does this look? Share with us at least how it begins. What? The eyeballs.
Yeah, are you? Are you asking me? Or...
I'm asking. Hello? I am asking Dal. Like what? Like, because Liam, what is it like? Hello.
Hello, doll. What's up? What do you need?
So I need to talk to someone. So I had a talk with my mom because I needed to talk and ask questions about my dad and his involvement in everything that's been going on, because I just have this weird feeling that he's involved somewhere in this, and like, he has weird connections, and the scientists knew me, and I just don't know what's going on. Talk to her. She flipped out, and like, she angry, and all I got from her was that my dad was just out on a trip, and he was doing some decoding for this alien language thing, and
you were looking through for connections between your dad and you're looking into his disappearance, and you know what happened.
There's
to
the kaboom. There was supposed to be an earth shattering kaboom.
Sorry. I was looking for just an explosion, but I got that instead.
Why do you sound so scared?
I'm just worried that this is not a good idea. I care about you. I don't want to see you hurt. You know, I'm very sorry you've been left without closure.
What do you mean? Like, I'm trying to get, like, you, why is it not a good idea? Like, my mom thinks that, like, I'm going crazy, like, my dad, it has no involvement, like, I gotta have, like, you gotta realize, like, he just disappeared, and nothing was told to me about anything, and I'm just freaking out, man, and you're telling me that it's not a good idea, when I know it is a good idea, because I want to figure out what my dad has to do with everything, and everything just seems like a big one, like, tangled spiderweb, and everything is connected, and I want to find out what it is.
This ship will self-destruct in 3 minutes.
Now, do you have some time to meet up and chat?
Tomorrow after my class.
Yeah, I think I might be able to help with some information on your dad.
Really? Wait, how do you know?
I think this is the kind of thing we talk about in person.
Okay, that's weirdly ominous. Well, I'll see you tomorrow. How about 2:30?
Sounds perfect.
Okay, have a good night. Thanks for the pep talk, I guess.
Liam, take guilty. Oh my god.
Emotional damage.
The whole time Liam's just like, oh shit, oh fuck, oh shit, oh shit, oh fuck.
Oh my god. The thing is that
it's emotional damage.
I mean, the thing is that her mom said terrorist attack in England. If Dahl actually stops for 10 seconds and puts all this together, yeah, of course Liam knows.
She also literally said the troubles.
Yeah. Like, there's a potential here that, like, 2 hours later, Dahl, like, puts all this together and goes, oh, he must know, like, he would have heard about this. I don't think it would still
It's worse.
I still don't think it would yet occur to her that he might have had something to do with it.
Yeah.
Wow.
I feel like Dahl's just going to show up, like, discussion, like, at a coffee shop. At Bake My Day, of course, because, duh.
But you should, though.
But, I feel like Dahl's just gonna come in, like, she knows a little bit, and, like, she knows, like, realize that Liam must know because he was living in Europe.
Yeah.
And had to do tribbles. So... She's already going in with, like, a little bit of a pissy mood because she made that connection, and thanks for not telling me earlier.
Yeah, here we go. So it's like this.
Emotional damage!
That's a lot of damage!
Yeah. I gotta say, one of the most effective things about my soundboard is the fact that I'm a member of so many EVE Online discords. because every single one of them has a massive library of stupid sounds that I can play for all of this. So it's really
can somebody please look at the memes channel and laugh at the drawing I put there, please? Oh, it's important to me.
The fuck is that?
Can someone please look at the chat and look at my beautiful drawing of Liam's costume?
Oh, is that?
I saw that, Jamie. It's incredible.
I thought that was the. What am I supposed to be looking at?
It's in the memes channel.
I'm looking at the memes channel. I don't
see
anything.
Yes, I'm wanted in 27 countries.
Oh, that's. I'm sorry. I thought that was the costume. Where's Jamie's? Oh, it's in the inspiration.
It's in the regular voice chat.
I also posted stuff in inspiration.
I mean, that is also a pretty good. That would be pretty good with the metal mask thing. I think you combine that somehow with the hooded thing, something. It's pretty good. We're getting there. Cool. We're getting closer. The bull helmet, though, that was some fine work there, Testerman.
Thank you. I put a lot of work into it. It took me a whole, 2 minutes.
That's sad, because mine took, a solid 10 to draw that stick figure.
Yeah, and yours is so much better than mine, dude. It's like you got the ginger hair in there, too. I'm actually going to use that.
Do you like the ab shading?
Yeah, it's good stuff.
Where are you talking about?
It's in the voice chat.
Oh, I haven't looked at. I gotta look at the voice chat. Man, there's too many chats. Oh, that is. See, I was looking at the inspiration thing for the other thing, but this is.
And I was gonna say something earlier about this when Dal was talking to her mom, but the thing in Japan where it's like the superstition of if you just sneeze out of nowhere, it's like somebody else is talking about you.
Yes.
Chris gets that, but it's when people purposefully don't use the word team in referring to the thing. It's not people talking about Chris. It's being the group, the squad.
Okay. Wow. Okay. All right.
Yeah, but that hurt real bad. Nice work, guys.
Yeah, thanks. That stung.
Yeah, I can kind of feel like it might have. Yikes. Meanwhile, Liam, you are also getting text messages from Chris throughout the evening with pictures of bull helmets and tactical body armor, but metal. Could you shape this? If you had this, could you use this stuff as weapons? Can you get your hands on this kind of, this thing says tungsten. Is tungsten something you can work with? Is that a metal? Because I want Chris to ask if tungsten is a metal. I think that's just.
Why are you not responding to me?
I'm trying to make you look amazing.
How abs are your abs?
Yeah, Jamie, I have to be really respectful of your ability to draw abs on what is essentially a very loose gray t-shirt. I'm not sure if the abs would show through that. But if they do...
I think they would.
I have to tell you, guys, because I did the thing this last week. Not this weekend, but last weekend where my kids and I went to... We ran up the... there's an amphitheater here that's up in the mountains. I don't know how to explain it except to say it's basically on the side of a mountain and it's surrounded by these rock formations. And then the amphitheater is at the bottom of this and as you're looking down at the stage, you're also looking out at Denver out in the plains. It's amazing. It's called Red Rocks. It's very difficult. It's a really cool venue, but it's also difficult for bands to play at because you're at 7,000 feet and you have to compete against the lights of the city and stuff behind them and everything. And me and my kids went and we ran it. We ran every row back and forth from the bottom up to the top and back down again.
I saw that Instagram post.
Which you wouldn't think would be that much. Kaylee, how you saw it, but do you remember how long that is? If you run every row
up and back,
5 miles. It's 5 miles. It's almost exactly 5 miles. It's ridiculous. But there's other people that work out there. They do all kinds of stuff. I saw one lady who was going up and she would do a double foot jump from one level up to the next seat level. And then she would jump back down and then she would jump up. And then once she got up to the level again and do the two hops, she would then do push-ups on the next seat row. And then she would do it again. And she went it all the way up.
I would fall and crack my neck open.
Oh, there was a guy who was running it from top to bottom, full tilt backwards. Okay. There was another dude who looked like he should be teaching a martial arts class, and he had this 4 foot long stick about this thick around with weights on one end, and it was about 4 feet long, and he was holding it straight out in front of him with the weights all the way up at the top. The weights were all, so he's holding them straight up, and he would step down, one step down where one foot was up and one foot was down on the steps, and then he would bring it around like this, and bring it all the way back around like this, and then bring it back up to a position, and then he would do another step down, and he walked all the way down and all the way back up doing this. But there was one guy who, I'm not even joking, if you took Chris Hemsworth in like Ragnarok, where he like the I'm only eating roasted chicken with no seasoning and drinking water for 2 weeks so I can just look ridiculously cut and my entire body is basically a V from the shoulders down to the waist. That guy, he was built like an anime character. It was absolutely insane. He was not wearing a shirt, so, but I think if he was, you could have still seen the abs through the shirt. Like, it was, he was legitimately a superhero build. It was impressive. And a very manly beard. The kind of beard that Superman would have. I don't know where I was going with that, except for the abs through the t-shirt thing led me astray.
Also, I made a really funny joke. James' abs are abs of steel.
Oh. Oh. That hurts. That hurts me. Okay, so Liam, are you doing anything other than just staring woefully at the ceiling for the rest of the night? Or what are you doing? Are you responding to any of these texts? Are you...
I think I'm responding to the text, but I'm... He's very uncommittal. Kind of like, oh, that's nice. Oh, okay. Very dejected, right?
The bull thing might work, I guess. The hood's nice.
Yeah, it's...
What are you thinking about doing with this conversation tomorrow? Does Liam legitimately not know? Like, I have to have some kind of conversation, but I don't know if I'm going to chicken out or not.
He's really torn on whether he's going to be, oh, it was my organization. It was, and just make up a story about what happened, or if he's actually just going to give her names and everything, make a very convincing story of like, just leave out the part that he was involved. Or if he's actually just going to tell the truth that he...
Oh, you know, boy. Because this would have been... Honestly, thinking about when this would have happened, this would have been pretty early days for you. Like, probably one of your first... Because this wasn't the one that made you leave. This is just one that happened. This is like the one where you like... You know, the concept in organized crime of being a maid... Being a made man is the ones in the mafia who have actually killed somebody as part of the job. They're the made men. They're the ones who are really committed. And kind of that, almost that idea of like, this is the one where you're going to go from being like an errand runner or delivery boy to being like a real member of the crew, you know, kind of deal.
Yeah.
Except now that you realize that the last name is the last name and wait, what?
Yeah.
Because this, I would say this is maybe not even one that really like kept you up at night until you met Dal and was like, oh shit, I actually know somebody whose dad was like shit. Except you can say it didn't keep him up at night, except how did you remember the guy's name if it wasn't something that you were carrying around somewhere in the back of your head?
Yeah, it wasn't the one that...
Made you leave.
Yeah, it wasn't the biggest of them all, but I think all of the people he killed, every bomb he set off or every attack he was a part of still haunts him. This one was just to a lesser degree until he realized, oh shit.
This one too, I will say, as you think, this is one of those ones, because you're thinking about it and like, what would you say? How can you change this? How can you like modify what you tell her? Do you even modify her? This is one that's always kind of stuck in the back of your head and itched because it felt weird at the time. Like it was different than the way than these kinds of jobs were usually run. They were kind of like dispatched. The way it came down was weird. There was most of these things were planned out pretty extensively. Like months, if not years in advance for like, we know in 2 years there's going to be this conference and we want to be there for this. And this was like, here is a satchel, be here at 2:30 this afternoon, go. Which is very atypical for how this stuff went down. Okay. It was weirdly short notice, but at the same time, incredibly specific. Like, we want the satchel in this particular cab. it needs to be, and then you hire the cab, you're going to hire the cab to go from here to here with the satchel. You're going to ride, but you're going to get out two blocks ahead of the actual destination and get out, and it's going to, you know, blah, blah, blah. And it was like to go to the the British Museum or whatever. And so it was just a really weird, everything about it felt off. Not at the time, but in hindsight, and now with this extra sort of scrutiny of thinking about it over and over, it's like that it has always bugged you. I don't know that you do. Oh, yeah. I don't know if there's something you want to do with that thought or not, but.
I think that definitely helps me prepare what I can, what I want to say.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Cool. All right. If you don't have anything you want to do right now, I'm going to jump over to Jamie and see what's going on with Calamity, and then we'll get around to. We're going to take another round around and end with you guys at the where are you meeting?
Bake My Day.
Oh, you're going to meet at Bake My Day. That's great. That there's no way that would go sideways. Excellent. Calamity. Hi.
Hey.
How's the van? Cold.
Honestly, van life's not bad.
Yeah.
She's kind of vibing with it. Because, like, okay, so when I'm thinking of the apocalypse, like, society has collapsed. But it's not like everything is, it's not like wasteland zombie apocalypse necessarily.
Sure.
Like, obviously, we have organizations, like we have rebel leaders and whatever. But like, I picture it as like either you're out on your own or you're in some kind of community. And if you're in a community, it's very like we all get a little space where you sleep. We all eat in the same, like I'm thinking Hunger Games, like the third Hunger Games, where they like they're in that bunker area.
Yeah, I know what you mean. There's a terrible one of my it's a very bad, it's one of my favorite bad movies. It's called Blood of Heroes, and there's a thing when these guys they're like a traveling, it's sort of like a traveling apocalypse football team. I don't know how to explain it other than that, but it's like a 5-man version of like, what if football was played on a court the size of a volleyball court, but it was all sand and it was played with a dog skull instead? It's terrible. It's terrible, but it's fantastic. Rutger Hauer's in it. But they get to an underground city, right? That's actually like organized, and it's where the rich people still live and stuff. And they rent a place to sleep. And what it is, they go into a huge cavernous room and they give a guy a little bit of money and they climb a series of like rungs that are into the wall, and they go up past, it's all these like, have you ever seen the pictures of people who like are climbing up a mountain, but they need to camp. So they build like the little platform. They like baton, they get the batons and just like spike a bed platform into the side of the cliff and just sleep there. It's kind of like that all the way up, and they just have to climb up far enough and then climb out onto the little bed platform and sleep. So you had that kind of a space. But a van is like luxurious personal space by comparison. It just gets a little cold in there.
I'm kind of living for it. And it's like, I don't have to, you know, work.
Living in an abandoned van is an upgrade.
Or any kind of, yeah, group. Like, I don't have to put in, like, hey, like, I loved my community. It helped me survive. But, like, it's nice. Like, I don't have to get up at dawn and do my piece of the work and whether that's going out on an errand run to like get more supplies or whatever, you know. So it's kind of like, ooh, this is cool.
I like the past. The past doesn't suck that bad, or at least as bad. I should keep it from not sucking. So the last we left you with was this weird kind of flashbacky thing where you remembered but didn't remember like an alternative version of rescuing Grant, where that was where something, possibly the thing, the big fog attack thing that started the chain reaction that led to the downfall of the world, like all of that happened. But that's not how it happened. It's almost like you had like sort of a nightmare where what was supposed to happen didn't happen and something else happened. Like, except it was, you were awake and it was a lot more like a memory, but it was a memory that didn't happen. So how are you, you're sitting there in the van. We see you like sitting, you're laying in the van, looking at the thing, feeling kind of comfortable. You look cozy. You're relaxing. You throw your head back on the pillow. You kind of let out a sigh. And then we see the flash to that scene of like the cloud pouring out of the ship and the cloud going across the water and hitting the docks and people screaming and all that. And you're like, duh, ugh. And we're back to you like with this, but it wasn't what happened. So what are you doing about that?
You cut out at the end there.
What are you doing about this? How are you dealing or not dealing?
I think, you know, kind of the moment of where like you're trying to sleep and then thoughts are keeping you up at night, right?
Yeah. Yep.
So like, she's just like laying there and then she's like, oh shit. Oh my God. Can't stop thinking about this. And then maybe she like, so her superhero costume originally was her normie clothes.
Okay.
But now as she's been living here, she's like, oh, I don't need to wear this to survive. I can just wear what everyone else is wearing, right? So she's like in quote unquote normie clothes, right?
Mm-hmm.
But she's having this memory nightmare of
not history.
Right, of the fog. So I think at first she tries like maybe just like grabbing her gas mask.
Okay.
And like holding it stuffy. That's really sad. like it's okay. Like I have the thing that will keep me safe. Like it's fine.
Okay.
And then I think that's not really working. So she just is like, I screw it. Like sleeping isn't working. So she has a lot of, like, she's taken a bunch of books from all of her library trips on all the respective like topics that she's been trying to look into. So I think she just like is like, I need to focus on something else. And she's trying to research.
Okay.
Like maybe it's the alien thing more.
Maybe it's the alien thing more. All right. So you have a thing. This is perfect because it goes right into one of your standard moves. At the start of a session or whenever time passes, roll to find out how your investigation into the timeline is going. So there's a button for it. You just have to hit it. It's the savior. It's right in the middle. And then there's like a, at the start of each session and thing, and they give you a savior button right there to roll. On a hit. It's not beeping for me today. Oh, look at that 11.
It's all right. A full hit right there.
So on a hit, choose one of the figures noted above. In this case, the only one you really have is Olifeist, or some one aspect of the future world that you can remember. You found a lead to follow to learn more about how the present version of that figure or aspect became the future version. On a 10+, the lead is particularly strong. Right now, you can ask the GM one question about the figure aspect, and they will answer honestly. So,
the dad is the martyr. The dad is the martyr. The dad is the martyr.
Mm-hmm. So, if you were looking at the alien, if you were looking at thinking like kind of researching more into the alien ship thing, we can go to that route. Yeah, for sure.
This kind of actually makes me think of, what the gas creates in people, like the fact that they're builders.
Yeah, they start building.
And if
weird
I can find anything on that, because from what I remember, in the future we still don't even know what they're building. We just know that they are.
Yeah, and because any place that they do that anywhere near any kind of settlement or anything like that, people try to stop them because they're also hostile and dangerous.
Right. They'll kill and destroy anything that gets in the way of them building.
Right. But that could also be happening out away from any of the points of light, like safe spots, and nobody would know because it's not where people are at, you know, or it's not anywhere near where you are anyway. So it has to do with the building and the alien stuff. All right. So I think that you've got all your sketches maybe that you've made from memory about how that stuff, like the partial builds and stuff that have been interrupted, and some of that. And there was something that's been bothering you about, there's just been something that's been bothering you and kind of sticking in the back of your head, and not, you start like grabbing, saying, wait a second, like something that I saw. It's one of those things where it's like, I was going to tell you something yesterday, but I can't remember what it is. I've been trying to remember what it is. So I'm just going to look at everything that I've looked at in the last 2 days and until I get to the thing that makes me think of the thing that I was going to tell you. It's so good that we all have the same, you know, mental broken bits. So handy.
It's called ADHD.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. The thing that... 10 reasons why van life sucks. The thing that you finally, as you're flipping through your notes and your sketch and your whatever, is I'm going to put this back into, I'm going to put it in the voice chat text thingy, Bob, is this thing, right? The actual picture of the thing, the crash spaceship that you saw. And you actually hear yourself talking to the team about this yesterday when you were asking about it. Like, you guys remember this with the spaceship? And like, it was out in the bay and people were working around it. And like, people were working on it. People were working on it. Why people? And you're looking at that weird structure that's built around it to kind of prop it up and stuff like that. It looks like the structures that the people build when they get infected. The ship does a little bit, but the thing around the ship definitely, and all these people that you saw that were like kept going and coming from the island with like the little boats is like constant activity. So, but the gas makes people do that, but the alien ship is the, and the, so what? What does that have
to do? It all feels like this weird paradox right now.
Yeah, because it doesn't, it like, it jives, but it doesn't jive. And what does Olafist have to do with any of this? Because he's like a dude from Ireland who's not, he's here now, but he's not here when the ship was here 4 years ago. That was not a thing. I don't remember when, Liam, how long has it been since you got activated? But it hasn't been 4 years since you got your powers.
I would say I've had them maybe 1 to 2 years, I think.
Yeah, so like... Olafice didn't even have powers when this was when you were back and saw the ship.
And like the things I know about the ship, that it disappears in time, and it's what contains the power cell that Liam, that future Liam, wanted me to get.
Yes. Also, it disappears is not exactly right. Like, people kind of remember that the ship was there, but then if you remember the people that sort of remember the ship being there, they're both like they were both like, I just feel like it, like. Yeah, it got cleaned up by, like, they cleaned it up and just moved it out. And they both said it exactly the same way. Like, the cadence was exactly the same. Everything was exactly the same. Do you remember the Doctor Who episode that was, like, with Chris, with Santa Claus? Where everybody, like, every time you ask for any extra detail about their backstory, they would say, it's a long story. It's like that. It's exactly like that. There's tomfoolery going on. There's time foolery going on.
Time foolery, for sure.
But yeah, future Liam sent you for the power cell. Was it from the alien ship or was it just a power cell?
I think I discovered last time when I discovered something about the alien ship that the power cell was related to.
Would have had to have been from there, but now it's not here.
Right.
And so is most of the, I mean, it's not here and so is most of the landmass that it's sitting on. It's as much, there's a little outcropping, like it's a place for birds to crap on and like some like that's it. I don't know what like water maybe there's otters, I don't know, out there, but it's basically a rock outcropping in the bay. It's not big. That's a whole island. Where'd the island go? Good question.
And like, besides the people building on it, who was on the island and where did they go? Like, where did they go? Why can no one tell me that? Where the fuck did they go?
That is an excellent...
I don't know, Jamie. It just got cleaned up.
Shut the fuck up! What?
Well, I mean, who would clean it up?
Initiative. Holy shit. I have to go talk to Initiative. Oh my god. I'm gonna go pee my ass.
You gotta go bang on Liam's door tonight. Boom, 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 boom.
I cannot mess with Liam anymore tonight. Like, I feel so bad for him. He's stealing.
No, you gotta just... It, I mean, he's the only person. How do you get a hold of Initiative? He apparently knows a bunch of them. They spent most of their time.
Go arrest somebody? I don't know.
They spent most of the time on the dock talking to him. They must be tight talking.
Yeah, realistically, I'm probably like I would have to go. And she wouldn't text.
Is it
she
the middle of the night or is it like, is it just, or is it middle of the night or is it like the first thing in the morning?
I think by the time that she makes that connection, she's like, okay, I can go to bed. And it's like 3 a.m.
So you sleep for and like 3 hours. And so she probably
sleeps for a long time because she hasn't really been sleeping.
That's so fair.
To like maybe match it all up, she's going to look for Liam around the time of Bake My Day. Maybe before, maybe after, I don't know, whichever's easier for you.
I think it's funnier if you're like at the door as he's going out, like with a heavy, like he's gone to his morning classes, come back, screwed his courage to the sticking place, open the door, and you're like, hey, I've got a question. Like as he's about ready to, hey, Liam.
Oh, that's so terrible. Liam, we're just like shitting on him.
Just cut me a break, please.
So you're heading out to Bake My Day, still trying to figure out what you're going to say. Still trying to figure out what it is you're actually going to say. And Calamity is at the door. What do you say? Because you don't know about any of this. Jamie does. See, can I just pause for a second? Because I want to... Some of you have played role-playing games before. Now, Jamie and Kaylee already know this, but this is why I don't do player secrets. You want to have character secrets? Fine. But the players, this would not be nearly as much good horribleness if we didn't all know. You know what I'm saying? Like it's
you have to know which parts of the armor you gotta stab at.
It's the fact
you can't just stumble onto the shit. You gotta attack it.
Liam getting called when Dal feels bad is like a good scene, but we don't understand that it's also a horrible scene if we don't know. And that's why like we have to remember that
honestly,
we're also the audience.
Poor Dal. Both of them. I'm so sorry. I just want to give them a hug. Oh my God.
I don't think, and I've had a reformed in one of my other games. I don't think that we really leaned into the, you hurt somebody, like a family member of somebody, like whatever that question was in the background. I don't think we used that with the other character because they came on in the middle of the campaign. They were a known NPC that somebody retired their other character and switched over to. So they were kind of known. So some of the stuff we sort of just, that doesn't really apply. Like we already knew their backstory, so we didn't do that. So this is the first time I've really had the opportunity of seeing what that does. And what it does is create a perpetual motion machine of pain and awkwardness.
Yeah.
It's pretty rough. Good job you taking it. You're doing hero's work here. After having done apparently a bunch of villains work. So good job. Anyway, sorry. We went off on a tangent there, but Calamity is at the door. Symbolically, Calamity is at your front door.
Calamity's probably like, hey, Liam, so glad I caught you. I, you know, was just doing some classic detective work. You know me, it's going to catch on. I have a couple questions. You're going somewhere.
This is a horrible time. I'm so sorry, but I would love to talk to you, but... I have to go.
Time earlier today was good for you?
That's just terrible.
Holy fucking God, yes.
I mean, I
that has gotta be the name of the episode.
I'm not sure. Calamity is at your front door is also a good one. You're going to create a paradox here. You realize that because he will still remember having this conversation later.
Is there not one? Because I can come back yesterday.
My first class is at 9:30. So like anytime before that, I guess.
Okay. Sounds good.
Wow. All right.
So then
to probably 9, but first she's going to write a note that says, when you see me later today and you tell me it's not a good time, tell me to meet you before your 9:30 class.
Wow. Okay.
Notes, get rid of paradoxes.
All right. So I'm going to have you unleash your powers. Because there's just so many ways this could go sideways. It's impressive, honestly.
It's a 7.
It's a 7. All right.
I will take unstable or temporary, please.
Unstable. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
That is certainly one word for what's happening right now. Unstable.
Okay. The conversation before you go. So, Liam, you're getting ready to move for class. You're still thinking about this conversation you have to have later. Calamity is there at the door. She hands you a note, first of all. She goes, okay, read this after I leave.
I need initiative's contact. Whoever you have an in with. Oh, because I'm pretty sure they're involved with this. It's kind of like a really long story, and I know you've got a lot of, or I think you've got a lot on your plate today. It kind of feels like a lot, but it's kind of like, I think they're involved with this spaceship thing that's involved with what we call the builders, that's involved with you sending me to get the power cell from the spaceship that's involved with the gas and the apocalypse. It's just like, it's a whole thing. So they're like my next lead, but I don't want to take up too much of your
time. Liam just kind of stares blankly for a second and goes like, yeah, I'll give you Agent Delaney's number.
Fantastic.
He's got too much on his plate to even try.
He's
to
like,
argue.
You know what? Here, just, you gotta write this number down. He grabs a different sheet of paper, hands it to you. And then he goes, you portal back to where, like,
good
your
luck.
The original starting time, or are you just going to start from here since you know that you're not out walking around? You should probably go back to your normal timeline.
Well, I'd probably tell him, good luck with, I don't know, whatever Debbie Downer thing you got going on today.
Wow.
I don't realize it's that serious. He just seems down, okay? Trying to be supportive.
If you want to talk later, you should definitely call Chris.
Yeah, like, I mean, totally, if you need to talk about it, like, you can talk to someone. Like, don't feel like you have to keep it inside.
You should definitely talk to one of the other people on the team, for sure.
I mean, like, I guess I'm here if no one else is available, but, like, you know.
Okay.
I'm here.
She probably then goes back to 10 minutes after, and...
The last conversation?
Yeah, 10 minutes after the last conversation, but not in the dorm. Like, she'll go, like, outside.
Okay.
Just to be safe.
So, you kind of, you don't know whether it's still not quite enough sleep or whatever it is, but you ever have the thing where you get, like, a sinus headache and it's fine, you don't actually feel anything, but when you bend over, it hurts? So, as you're trying to do the thing where you go outside, it just, you kind of lose your grip a little bit and you slide sideways a little bit further, and you end up at Amphitheater Park.
Who would have thought?
There's kids playing around. They're out in the snow, like they're doing various stuff. One of them sees like the portal, and like you kind of step out, and there's a little bit of a trip stumble kind of a thing, and he just like,
he's like, here again?
Yeah, you're busy doing that. He runs up, like, that was amazing. How did you do that? Who are you?
Kid, I stopped asking questions so long ago.
But can I ask? Because that was amazing. Are you a superhero? Tell me everything. Tell me all of it. I want to be a superhero.
Please, for the love of God and everything good in you, Calamity, entertain this child.
I'm not a superhero, but I'm a time traveler.
That's even better! That's like a superhero, but everywhere! That's so cool!
Oh, cool!
No, like, wait, who are you? Tell me everything. I want to know everything. He's like 10. He's like, so picture Zoe,
right,
but a boy.
Okay.
All right. So that level.
It's definitely kind of like hitting her. It's breaking down her bitch part. You know, she's like, man, I really can't be a bitch to this kid.
He's coming at you. Really nice. He's coming at you with 100% zero cynicism on this. This is just absolutely do you have like a code name? Do you have like a And he's got like sort of the Canadian Frenchish accent, but it's pretty low key. Like it's just a touch.
Don't be who I think you are. Okay.
No, I'm just
about to have that same feeling, Jamie.
Yeah. Okay. Well,
he's
you know,
10.
Let's start over. And I reach. Put my hand out, and I'm like, "Hi, I'm Charlie." Like I'm trying to shake his hand. Hello.
Shit, I need a name for this guy. Hang on. Sorry. Apparently, I've searched for this before.
Jackson.
No, I need.
Does he not have hands? Have I made a terrible mistake?
No, yes.
Okay.
What a thing to ask.
Well, because like I was like, I'm trying to shake his hand, and you just go silent.
No, I'm sorry. I was looking up. I needed a name for him, and I didn't have a name.
Oh, got it. Okay.
I'm gonna go with. I don't want to do that because it's too close to Liam. Noah or
Owen.
Noah or Thomas.
Jackson.
Noah.
Thomas. Okay, we're gonna go with Noah.
Fuck.
Why is that? Okay? So yeah, I'm Noah. Can you do it?
Hold on, I gotta answer your other questions. Wow. Okay.
Okay.
So, also known as Calamity.
I've never heard of you. That's so cool.
Yeah, that's because I'm from the future.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, because you're a time traveler and you're not from the past, because we would have heard about you if you're from the past, because you'd be super famous and we'd hear about you. Yeah, okay.
So why do you want to be a superhero?
Because it would be, I want to help people, and I think I could do more if I had like a superpower. And I couldn't do that, but can you show me? Can we do it? Can you just take me across the park? Like just over to the shell.
Have you ever wanted to see something really cool? And if so, what is it?
Like every day.
Like I'm thinking of a time or a place, right? Like what is the place you've always wanted to be, or is there a time you've always wanted to go to? But it can't be anywhere you've been before.
No. Well, I'm like, I don't take up much time. So, cause I'm just 10. So I want to see, oh God, I got to think of something good. There's a terrible thing I want to see, and then there's a like kind of a normal thing I want to see.
What about dinosaurs?
That'd probably be a little bit long. Can you show
it's
me?
Hard.
Can you wait? Where are you from? Oh, you're from the future. You probably don't care. Can I see? I can't decide if I want to be this much of an asshole with this kid, but it might make you fall in love with him.
Do not do World War II or the French Revolution.
Can I see when we burned down their White House? What's that, Kaylee?
Somebody loves this child.
I was hoping something more like France, but sure, why not? Get on my back.
No, I got in an argument with one of my friends about whether or not we lost or whether or not we won, and I just wanted to... You're welcome.
In the making.
Yeah, that's why it's so cool. I just want to go across the park. You don't have... But if you're going to take me someplace cool, that would be cool.
All right, and I give him a piggyback ride, and hope I don't slip this time.
I fucking love this kid. Can I please get a fucking wholesome interaction with a child, please?
Okay, I'll work on that. Well, you have the news kids.
Put that on my fucking wishes,
okay? Wholesome interaction with a child.
Fucking rocks.
All right. Okay. Okay. So yeah, I'm not gonna make you roll because it's just kind of cool. I will make you roll. Actually, yeah. Let me think about this for a second.
I run into Alex and he's like, "Do you have a kid?" I'm like, no, I just stole him from the park. Don't worry about it.
So when you get ready to move, and it isn't enough because this is how Charlie works. It isn't enough to make you actually pause. But when you figure out your beginning and end points, you're at the park. You knew that. But as you start to kind of figure out your anchor points and stuff, you're not in your current time year. You slipped in distance and in time. It's like... 15 years back. So just remember, when you bring him back, you need to bring him back to 15 years before your current timeline, because you went out to the park, but you also went back like, actually, just to be a complete fucker, I'm going to say 17 years, because that's when, or 16 and 16 years and change, because that's when the girl was born in the city. So you slid back to that spot in time, like there's a divot in the ground kind of a thing. So you as you're getting it, it's like, oh shit, this would be, why did I go back? Oh shit, that's when the girl was born. Fuck, I'm going to have to remember where this is. And then you go. So yeah, oops. So yeah, you go back, you get to see the sacking of the original White House. He asks like 3 times if he can take pictures. No, can't take pictures. He wasn't really expecting you to take pictures. There's no signal. And then by that point in time, he's kind of yawning, like, because it's been a little bit. And he's like, no, this is really cool. Like, his excitement level is still there. You get this sense that he's excited, but he's also tired, but he's trying to keep his energy level up because he doesn't want you to feel like he's not excited anymore. And then you won't feel appreciated. So he's trying to like push to continue to act like this is the coolest thing. Because it is, but he's tired.
How does this kid know that the reason why I started liking him is because I felt appreciated? What the heck?
I'm just modeling this off of Zoe, because I've seen her actually do this where she's tired, but she's still trying to let you know that what you did was cool. But she's also like completely done. So you get him back to the thing. Like totally. At the right time.
You said he was 10?
Yeah, he's like 10. You need to get back at the right time because my brother is, he's going to leave, but he's going to be back and I need to meet with him. What?
Is his brother the speedster? Dad, that's an evil, look at his face. That's
totally
an
fucking
evil
is.
Face.
It totally fucking is. It totally is. Fucking idea.
I promise his brother isn't the speedster. I promise.
So it's someone else important.
Or some kind of relation. His best friend, maybe. The guy arguing with him. Of course the French would think that we lost the war. He's definitely the best friend that this guy's arguing with.
I want you to hear this from my heart. I promise that his older brother is not the speedster.
It's his younger brother, then.
He doesn't have a younger brother.
What? So then his older brother is someone else important? I bet it's like fucking Olifeist or something.
Yeah.
Look at that face!
No. That's funny, though, but no. No. Okay, so he gets out to the thing. He's great. He gives you a huge hug.
What's
a squeeze.
What's your last name, kid?
Puts all of his squeeze into it.
Actually, before he goes, I'd like, actually, what's your last name?
Hang on. I don't know. Make me do these things.
Does it happen to be the sprinter by any chance?
No.
Bitch.
Oh, no, that's
when
terrible.
When your last name is actually just the sprinter.
The sprinter.
That's not even his superhero name. His full legal name is just Alex the Sprinter.
Oh, this is terrible. Leclerc. Noah Leclerc with a C at the end instead of a K.
She makes a mental note to keep an eye out for him and anybody in her future, or like, well, I guess her present.
Okay.
Like the future, which is her present.
Yes.
That is
absolutely
related to her future. Now, that is related to him.
I want you to remember what I said, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, you open up your portal to go back, and he's still like, this is so cool. And I got to go through it, and it's just tingly. I'm tingly. Come back and visit. And as you're stepping through, he turns around and he's running. He goes, he's running. And you hear him shout, Alexis, Alexis, you'll never guess what happened. But remember what I said. The older brother is not the spirit star.
It's his best friend. Like,
it's his best friend.
Or
it's his best friend.
Or it's his dad, which would be terrible.
Shoom, shoom, shoom.
But why would he say Alexis? It's the fucking best friend. He already wants, Noah wants to be a superhero. Duh, because his best friend is ours.
His best friend is so French. Right.
And a fired and a missed and a fired and a missed and a fired again and a missed and a missed and a missed and a fired and a missed.
It doesn't matter. All we know is that he's related in some way. Like, he has connection.
But he's adorable and he's the best.
This is true. He is pretty great.
Noah Leclerc.
All right. And then I think she would go back to her. She'd actually go back to her timeline this time and head off to initiative.
Yes. Yes. You didn't have, probably, yeah. Okay, so we're going to do that. Now, it is We got just enough time. But I want to cycle back around to Kaylee. Do you have anything that you want to be doing here?
Dude, I got my moment. Honestly, I would love to have a little cutback of like she's reading out the names to her sister, and they're just the worst things that you've ever heard.
Okay,
let me
hear these team names. I want to hear these team names.
The Remedy Champions, the Monster Syndicate, the Fruitcakes, the Prodigy Masters.
The Fruitcakes? Why are you what?
The Zealot Watt. Kickers Incorporated. Platinum.
Platinum?
Power Pack. The Anomalies. The Crazed. No. The Children of Mountain Goats.
The what?
Did you just say the Children of Mountain Goats? Can I hear this right?
Remedy sent me this. And I actually think it has some... something to it. Those were all one-ups, you know, my little ones, you know, just get you warmed up to the idea. I will read you this text. Hyper big slimy frog / gymnastics. One text. Healing. Second text. Wings. Third text. Metal. Time travel. Team name? ? The Foretold.
I want to hate it.
Right? And then the scene just ends.
Like, I want to hate it, right? And then, yeah.
Yeah, I literally just found the worst superhero names I could find and put them on a list. I love Kickers Incorporated. That came up. That was really fucking funny.
Kickers Incorporated is pretty good, I think. Power Pack's terrible. And
I'm sorry, what the fuck was that?
The
only other one that I actually liked other than the Foretold was Myriad, because it's just fun.
Mm-hmm. The first group that we did, everybody just threw up their hands and just said, we're just going to call them the Menagerie, because there isn't anything that ties them all together. So fuck it. It's just a collection.
And it was gorgeous.
Yeah, I think Myriad is pretty good as well.
Myriad isn't bad. Foretold, man, that's got some, like...
It's got something. It's kind of fun.
It's got like a... It's got a sound that should be coming with it or something.
Just, and I just read to you the note that Remedy gave, that Yosvin gave to me. And I just like them as texts, because Remedy would absolutely just like, no context whatsoever, just listing all of our superpowers and then team name, The Foretold. Like, I think that's really funny.
The Foretold sounds like it should be coming with, like every time anybody says it in the news, it should be coming with this sound. Oh, I know.
I was literally thinking about that. The.
Whoa. I'm playing the sound again. This should be a sound that we have in our sound, our thing. We need this Inception bomb. Liam, you get there first, because that's how mean I am. Can you turn on I want to see your camera. Can you turn on your camera? Or is it going to make everything go all terrible?
You can give it a shot. Try.
Okay, so you get there first.
Amazing glasses, by the way.
Thank you, I got them today.
I will do you the kindness of saying that Remedy is not there. What are you going to do? How do you prep? Do you order a drink for her? Do you get a chocolate-filled croissant? Do you...
I think he gets two drinks. He ends up chugging his.
As you do.
And then looks at the drink, chugs the other drink. and I think he gets two more. I think he can't sit still. He's fidgeting the whole time. He's pulling out his hair. He's not... the caffeine is definitely not helping at this point either. He's just...
Oh, man. Okay. So
I love the idea that she just sits down. She's like, "Hey, I killed your dad."
That sounds.
Sorry, get that out.
Okay. So what I'm gonna Dal. Has any of the stuff that we talked about occurred to you leading up to this? Like, he may know something about this. This was a terrorist attack in Britain.
I feel like made like some sort of a connection, and she's like, okay, like you definitely know something.
So you're kind of going in here expecting him to have information. Yeah. Okay. All right. Fair enough.
I can see myself sitting down and just be like, spill the beans. You got some. She was.
So, what are you doing?
I think as soon as Dal walks in, he gets up really awkwardly. He kind of motions to the seat and the drink. He pulls it out for her. He's going way over the top with the gentleman, but he's still visibly shaking.
Maybe if I pull Dal, the chair for her, she won't hate me after I tell her I killed her dad.
Dal comes in and this is like a little bit too much like a date here. A little awkward.
Really not what you were going for. You poor people.
Oh, yes. Date, funny. You're funny. Just the awkward. God damn.
Yeah, that would be. So, your information on your dad. Right, that's
information. Yeah. Your dad.
So I was thinking a little bit because he died on a trip. He was in Europe, and you used to live in Europe, right? And you're in on things that happened there, right? It was about 4 or 5 years ago, give or take.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm going to tell you the story of my first mission.
Oh.
It was very very different than most of the missions I'd either heard of or had anything to do with in the past. It was very rushed, very very last minute. He said something about a British museum and deciphering an alien language, and they gave me a satchel. Let me get into a cab, and I blew up the museum. Your father's name was in the casualty list.
You killed my dad?
Yeah. I am so so sorry, and please please know that I am.
You killed. She screams this out into the baked my day, like everyone turns around. Oh. And she's just like starting to like cry, and she's like, huh, what? And you knew? You didn't tell me?
I didn't know how to tell you. I'm so so sorry. I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't realize any of this was real at the time. You know, I just thought I was doing what was right by my country. I'm so sorry that I
took away my best friend.
Yeah.
And my mother's best friend. And my brother's dad.
So
my brother was born.
Is Grant with you, like in your bag?
No, he stayed up.
He stayed at home? Okay.
He stayed up.
Okay.
He was too busy playing on his iPad.
So, Liam, you get to live another day.
Thank God the frog's not here.
Oh my God. Okay. So,
but like, there's just like a scene where it cuts to Grant, and he's just like,
because you psychically linked, right?
Yeah. Like, he's just on his iPad, and he kind of just like looks at the game, and he's like sets it down. He kind of just like slumps on the bed, and he's all sad. He doesn't know why.
He's just picking up vibes.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Grant's gonna give you the side eye every mission, just to let you know that.
So here's the thing. I kind of want you both to take a powerful blow, but I'm gonna begin with Dal.
Okay. This has actually almost got me crying in real life.
I'm sorry, and you're welcome. This is a lot.
Kiernan, I forget really fast. I'm just, have you talked about how you came to be in the terrorist group?
I don't think he has, like, told people that.
I don't know.
Well, like, I mean, not. Like, as players, like, do we know? Like, do you
I
know?
I think I said, like, the first, I do, yes.
Yeah.
I said the first our sessions.
Like, you didn't have family and they basically raised you.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Just, yeah.
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 All right, sorry. Wait, I just didn't remember.
The players know that. I don't think any of the characters. Say that again.
Which one do I roll?
You roll conditions up at the top of your thing.
Leo.
To kind of pick up from this terrible moment, I'm drawing Liam's redesign right now, and holy shit, I love it a lot. There's knee pads, there's a vest with a hoodie attached, and there's a fucking sick ass helmet.
Okay.
So
I'm fascinated by this because somehow you rolled through this. So when you take a powerful blow, if you, on a miss, you stand strong. Mark potential as normal, so you get to mark potential. You still need to figure out what your other advance is, by the way. So we need to go back to your playbook and look at that. But you're now up to... Let the record show she's up at 7 at this point. On a miss, you stand strong. Mark potential is normal. And say how you weather the blow. Like, how do you come out of this essentially intact? Because I was all ready for you to have a 10 and have the... You lose control of your powers in a terrible way, being Grant goes berserk back at your house from the emotional blowback. But that's not happening. So explain how.
So she kind of just like goes on like a, like everything's processing and everything's like clicking. And she's like, oh my God, I knew he would know something, but like, I didn't know he was one who killed my dad. But she kind of like calms down. She's like, that was a past Liam activity.
Wow.
Wow. And instead,
past Liam behavior.
And I was like, I know he has connections to what my dad was doing, and that was my main goal in this, was to find out what he was doing, not how he died, perchance. So I'm gonna direct it back at like, well, that was interesting, but
oh wow,
is there any,
she's really compartmentalizing on this hardcore.
Yeah, like, could you, like, do you have a way of finding out like more about what happened and what he was involved in?
Yeah, of course I can get you in. I can contact, or I can get you in contact with the organization.
Anything. Oh shit! Okay.
Wait, can you repeat that? I didn't hear it.
He's gonna.
I said.
Go ahead.
Sorry.
No, you do it. Go for it.
I said, I can contact, or I can get you in contact with the organization. Anything you need.
That is not what I was expecting you to do, but wow. Okay. That'll be great.
I think he's, whatever she says, he's going to do.
Yeah, no.
He's
under my thumb. Jamie's just like, oh my God. Wow. Oh my God. God.
No, the fact that you were like, I think this is past Liam behavior, that part almost made me cry. I was like, oh my God. Like, because it's like the people love redemption arcs, right? It's this whole redemption thing. And it's.
That's a lot.
The fact that the person you hurt can even see the ex-villain as redeemable?
Well, I mean, it's not the person you hurt. The person you hurt is dead, but, you know.
No, but, like, the person he hurt is the family, you know? Like, they're the ones who are emotionally hurt, you know? So.
Yeah, yeah. But, you know, the one that he actually hurt got blown up, you know?
Okay. Okay.
Oh, boy. Okay, so.
What a gorgeous moment.
It is.
Yeah.
Liam, I'd like you to take a powerful blow because this is a lot. And even if it's functional and good on her part, I want to know how you're dealing. Not as good. So, okay. First of all, before we figure out of like an option off the menu kind of whatever thing, she is really processing. She is being incredibly like, cool isn't the right word, but like totally like under control about this. I am like, what does that feel like as an initial like just gut reaction thing for Liam?
I think what's kind of going through Liam's head is, holy shit, she's not reacting. She's just gonna stab me. There's like, she's just gonna kill me. She's not gonna yell and scream. She's just gonna.
Which tells you a little bit about what Liam's life has been like. They're really mad if they're not yelling. Actually, I'm going to ask this question because we're getting close to time. So on the 7 to 9, you lash out verbally. These are your options. You lash out verbally. You give ground. Your opposition gets an opportunity. I suddenly and very intensely have an idea for that if you decide to pick that one. And you struggle past the pain, mark 2 conditions. Yeah, I know. They're not 7 to 9 on take a powerful blow sucks. It's really hard every time. I'd almost rather have a 10.
Except for those times where I used to take 2 from the 7 to 9 list.
Yeah.
Because I wanted to take 2 struggle past the pain and mark 2 conditions.
You wanted the conditions because you're a damn suffer hound.
I think I'd like to give ground.
Okay. So, Al, what was the last thing you said to him? Just right before the end? After you kind of rode through this?
Yeah, like I kind of repositioned what like I was here to do, and like I want to find out more information on my dad, and not so much on how he died, but like what he was involved in, like what he was actually doing before he died.
Gotcha. Excellent. And because you're giving ground here, I'm just going to do a little bit of speaking for you, Liam, if that's okay. So Liam, like, yeah, no, absolutely. I can, I'm going to get in touch with some folks back in the organization and we'll get you in touch. I just need to go and make sure that the numbers that I still have are still up to that they're still the right ones. And then I'll get in touch with you later today. If that's good, I'm going to go. And he kind of gets up and just stumbles, like the chair kind of almost tips over, rocks back on his feet. He kind of rushes out the door, hurries out the door. I don't say rushes, but hurries out the door, does it head down, hoods up, not really looking around, turns and goes down the street. And you kind of watch him go out through the door and then kind of let your vision drift back to the, you know, kind of to the left and, you know, from the door back through the big window that's on the street. And there's two people standing there at the window looking in, like right at you.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Uh-oh.
And they're the two people on the left are the ones that are standing outside.
Oh, fuck.
And
God, Dal, you're cooked.
The girl kind of,
you're done.
The girl kind of like, she's got her one arm across her chest and she kind of rests her other arm on the other, you know, on the other one and kind of does this little wave. And then she pulls out this piece of paper and sticks it up to the window. And it says, come outside or everybody in there dies. And we're going to stop there.
Okay.
What the fuck do you mean we're stopping there? What kind of a cliffhanger is that? That's not okay.
So, party time. I'm going to start with Chris, because Chris didn't have a lot of interaction with other people. So, closer to the team, further away from the team, more into your own image of yourself.
Probably in my own image of myself.
Okay. Tweak your labels. One up, one down.
Alexis, you won't believe what happened.
Jamie, closer to the team, further away from the team, more into your own image of yourself.
More into my own image of myself.
Okay.
I'm going to fucking hate myself for this. I did mundane up and danger down, so my danger's at a -2 now.
Ooh. I definitely need to shoot your ass. The best part is I'm kind of getting a picture in the back of my head of where some of this is going, and it is...
Isn't it horrendous?
It's... there's some good... like, you guys have given, like, done some stuff in here that is just... delicious.
Yummy.
Miss Yummy, closer to the team, further away from the team, more into image of yourself.
I was going to say that I grew farther away from the team just because, like, found out that one of my team members was
fighting
this big... Yeah.
This seems entirely fair. So when you do that... When you do that, you take influence away from somebody who has influence over you that is on the team. It seems like that should be Liam. Does that seem fair?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So, Liam, the bad news is that you don't have influence over Stick right now. I know you're terribly surprised by that. the good news is it does give you a point of potential. So,
yay!
Wait, I already checked it, but I will. So I will uncheck that one. But okay.
See, you can get potential, Kiernan.
You have like.
You just need to do really shitty first.
You have like 2 now. You should have more than that. Did you already take an advance? You should have more than that.
No, I don't think she
literally doesn't fail rolls.
Well, I get that, but...
I've never failed a roll.
You should be...
Like, unfortunately, I have to applies to take a...
When you grow closer to the team at the end of the session, which I think you've done at least a couple times, you're supposed to take potential, or you could clear conditions. Have you been doing nothing but clearing conditions?
This is my first condition, I think.
Okay, so... I tell you what
somebody
I'll do.
Somebody might be having to listen through all the sessions and figure out how much potential Liam needs.
Yes. I will go back and look.
I know how fast he has drawn closer to Calamity at least twice.
Yeah, I can think of twice I did that. That might be it, actually.
Have you not grown closer to anybody yet? Well, Chris. I have influenced by Chris.
Chris, yeah.
And Charlie.
Oh, no.
Chris already had it because you guys started out with influence and then Charlie, but you had Charlie twice. I think you've got, yeah. I'll go back and listen and see if there's anything more than that. But because there was also Stick was also on there, too. So,
there's a few.
I'll go back and listen because you should when you grow closer to the team, you either get potential or you clear condition. Okay. So that there's a certain amount of kind of, I don't say guaranteed, but generally speaking, people usually grow closer to the team. And you certainly have the opportunity now because you've got some gaping holes now in your trust network anyway.
Everybody's wet.
Liam, closer to the team, further away from the team, more into your own image of yourself. More into your image of myself, and I hate myself, so I'm going to lower all my stats now. What do you think?
I was thinking more into the image of myself, and I was wanting to put Danger up and Mundane down.
Sure.
Just thinking that he's a monster.
As long as neither of those go.
I can't do that.
What's your Danger at?
We already.
Oh yeah, so you can give myself a condition. You can still do that option. You just have to move different stats. Like you could raise your freak too.
Freak would be
good because that's unleash your powers.
Yeah.
What's your mundane at now then?
Zero now.
God, you guys are just social disasters. Every last one of you.
I moved my mundane down and my superior up.
This, I think, may hit the high water mark for the most painful, like, reveal between characters. Like, I've done some pretty horrible shit with, like, NPCs dropping bombs, but...
That was pretty rough.
Player to player, this was practically PvP. While, like, you're shooting somebody in the kneecap and going, I'm so sorry. Liam just needs to fail some rolls.
Yes.
Clearly.
Like he has been, but for some reason he hasn't.
Yeah, it's been like missed. Yeah, I don't know. Because he got smacked up against the wall that one time. I think that was you defending somebody,
I had an option to like deflect my opponent's blows or something. I chose not to.
Right, right. And
every time I take a powerful blow, I roll high.
Yeah, because you were taken out by that. You got knocked out from that one hit. Yeah, you're right. It's been a weird. I had this with somebody. I've had a couple of characters that, you know, they just for whatever reason it doesn't quite click right away. Actually, Kaylee had the longest fucking run where she didn't level up with her first mass character. Jamie had three or four advances before Kaylee got her first one.
Seriously.
To be fair, Jamie was like. Seriously, seven different kinds of garbage with her dice. It was.
She was gunning.
I was like farming advancements.
Also, I think it's very important to note that I have added a sound to our soundboard.
Yeah.
Very important. Now we have that for, you know.
I have an important question for everyone.